Back here to SAP Center. Almost a whole period has gone by. We haven't even told you yet that the Sharks acquired a new player today. They signed lifelong fan 18-year-old Sam Tagason to a one-day contract. Now, Sam has been dealing with a heart condition ever since birth, and thanks to the Sharks Foundation and the Make-A-Wish Foundation, he got to practice with the team today, meet the general manager Doug Wilson, and then this. He got to skate out of the Shark Head for tonight's game. It's the first time ever the franchise has allowed somebody beside a player through that Shark Head for the game. There you see him showing on the Jumbotron as the whole crowd gave him an ovation. Randy and Drew, I know we're the guys that are supposed to have words, but watching this scene unfold, literally I was left with none. Total goosebumps, a total emotional scene here. I've never seen anything so touching in 5 years of covering this team.
It wasn't easy, but it was enjoyable for Patrick Maroon and the Edmonton Oilers. I mean, this is one of those games that I guess you kind of expect because of the way your team is now built and the way the Blues are built.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, first period wasn't really our period. I thought the goalie handled the puck too much for us to get our forecheck. And then the second and third period, when we dump pucks in, we're a hard team to handle. We have a really big team up front, and it starts with our fourth line, and big guys like me, Luch, Cass, Letestu, Hendricks, Drysdale, we go on there and protect pucks and we create offense and energy for our team, and that's what we need to do every night.
Is that kind of what led to what turned into an important goal to at least give you a point, your goal out front and the deflection?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we had a really good break out there and Nuge came in and supported, and you know, Drysdale came in and, you know, great play, and just, we just got it through. And you know, I always tell myself I have to get to the net, and you know, good things happen, so, you know, it felt good tonight, especially in my hometown.
Yeah, well, the goal was great, but I wonder what you think of this reaction by your son and family.
It's pretty cool. Pretty emotional, but I don't get to see him as much, and it's pretty special.
Yeah, and he thinks that of you as well. Hey, Patrick, thanks a lot. Christmas is on the way. More time with Anthony.
Absolutely.
Okay, thanks, Patrick. Appreciate it.
I got some teammates right here on the bench that we played with a bunch of years. Just want to thank you guys for the few years. You guys are a great group of guys, and I'm really proud of you. And I think that we have to believe in ourselves right now and enjoy the moment. Just relinquish in it and come out here and have fun, because you never know when you're going to have an opportunity to either compete in an NHL game, compete in a playoff hockey game, get to the Stanley Cup final, or ever win a Stanley Cup. So, to the love of my life, Gina, I just want to thank you for being on this journey with me. I know it was not always easy, and there were some long road trips, but there was nobody else in the world that I would have rather spent it with, so you're my life, and I love you forever. Just want to thank the fans. Thank you, everybody. It's been a great ride. It's been amazing. It still is amazing when I walk in the community and talk to you guys and see other grocery stores. You guys have been behind me from day one, and I'm truly humbled to have been through this journey with you guys, and thank you for the support over the years. Sometimes we're great, sometimes we're not so great, but you guys always stuck behind me, and I truly appreciate that.
It is now time for a first in Panthers history. A player number will be retired. Roberto, family, make your way down the red carpet. No Panther will ever wear number one again. Congratulations to you, Roberto, who you are not, in your own words, just another retiree in South Florida. He continues to work to bring a Stanley Cup here. Thank you to everyone for being here and showing Roberto and his family your support.
Joe Pavelski back here at SAP Center, and it is a return that everybody in this building has been waiting for, regardless of what side of the ice you're on.
Said it'll be a little weird and awkward just seeing the jersey and being back in this building, and they are showering him with love right now.
There's a pregame presentation going on right now. We'll join in with everybody here checking out the highlights of Joe Pavelski in San Jose.
Thornton centers. Datsuka down the score. Joe Pavelski.
Hello. My name's Nathan, but my dad plays for the Sharks, and he's the captain.
Get in there, get in there, get up.
No goal.
No goal. Good shot.
You guys want a Netflix and chill?
Semaphore!
Ocho on fire!
You have a pumice stone for like this?
I approve this message.
Yeah, man!
Looks across, great pass! Big stop rebound! Scores! Joe Pavelski!
Meyer Pavelski! He scores!
The best tipper in all of the National Hockey League!
Shoots one and scores!
Point burns the shot. Star! Guess who tipped that puck in front of the net? That's right, it's the captain, Joe Pavelski. And the Sharks take the 1-0 lead in Game 7.
Welcome back, Joe Pavelski. And thank you for 13 seasons of Sharks hockey.
They say memories always fade with time, but they don't age a day. And they loved and loved Joe Pavelski here in San Jose. How is he going to play the game after this? Those eyes are moist.
first is only 35. And he's out there. Jágr, Herdina. Jágr with it. Lemieux in the middle. Lemieux.
Baby, this is priceless. All Mario Lemieux had to do was raise his stick when he got open, and Jágr spotted him right away. He said at the end of the first period, now if I can only get my hands back. They're back. Jágr made this play happen. He curled it back to the boards once he took Juszkiewicz deep. Mario had his stick in the air. It came out to him, and he took something off of this one-timer to make sure he hit the net. Bang! You can only imagine how good he feels right now. And only Gordie Howe and Guy Lafleur can relate to this. Maybe a couple others, like even before we were born.
And here's a two-on-one for Ottawa. Paulin tried to center, and Quinn Hughes able to block the pass. Now it's center to Ryan, he shoots, he scores!
And here's Bobby Ryan, and around the net, makes such a good, smart shot. Up foot to stick, and then by Thatcher Demko, and you can hear the crowd hollering, Bobby, Bobby, is... So quickly he got that foot to the tip of his stick, and because he got it on the toe, he was able to get it up and over Thatcher Demko.
Just below the goal line. Gave it away. Zaitsev long shot. Tipped in. Bobby Ryan.
Takes a look. Throws it up. And he's trying to hit Adam Gaudette with it. And Bobby Ryan with a beautiful little tip in as he gets off the boards first in front of Fanberg. And you can see Fanberg knows he's in trouble.
And Quinn Hughes didn't sell it for the icing. And an empty net. Hat trick for Ryan.
Oh, Bobby Ryan, an emotional comeback. Well chronicled story of his plight and able to get back and play, and there he gets a beat for the empty netter. Quinn Hughes was trying to sell the icing, and by the time he got back, he was checked. The linesman waved the icing off, and the Senators took advantage.
Well, if the Canucks were going to go down in this game, might as well make it an emotional one for the Ottawa Senators and their fans. And Bobby Ryan, you see the emotion overcoming him now. Played his first game back in Nashville. Senators lost that one 3-2. But look at this. In his return to Ottawa, and he's got Asher.
Turns up with it, left it behind, got it back again, and played to the outside. And taken back for a shot, and Pat stopping by Curry. They score! And who else?
It's a different vibe here. Kreider chips it in deep, but Tang can't. Now the forechecks engage. There's Stepan in the live legs. Spinnerama creates some time and space. St. Louis out front. Quick shot on goal. Rebound. Marty St. Louis off his pads. And behind Marc-Andre Fleury. That goal will count. It's not a distinct kicking motion. Never touches skate. There's Kevin Pollock. But for the Pittsburgh Penguins, a really long shift for Malkin, Crosby, and Kunitz. They couldn't get back. But a great forecheck play by the Rangers.
Ladies and gentlemen, though Gordie Howe rewrote the NHL record book, no statistics can quantify the number of players he inspired, the number of fans he thrilled, and the wonders he performed in his legendary NHL career. Before the San Jose Sharks and Pittsburgh Penguins resume their quest for the same historic trophy he won four different times, we pause to celebrate the remarkable life of the incomparable Gordie Howe.
Mr. Hockey, Gordie Howe.
Gordy just has a special gift with people. You can tell when you meet him. Within 5 seconds, you'll be best friends with Gordy because you think you knew him forever.
I played head-on-head against him for many years, likely some of the greatest games that I was ever involved in.
My dad lived by example, showed us how to be by example, and just to watch what he could do every day and dominate.
I learned a lot of things in life and in hockey from Gordy, and what he did for our game and how he handled himself as a person. I was just really lucky. He was a wonderful guy.
Gordy Howe leaves a legacy of devotion to his family, to his teammates, and to the greatest sport in the world. He is forever Mr. Hockey.
Moments ago, a class act for a class act, a standing ovation and a welcome back for Matt Sundin, who's having a tough time handling this, and the referees have backed off. Good for Derek Amell, the linesman, yep, just to wait this out, because this is one of the toughest faceoffs Matt's ever taken.
That's a appropriate response to a guy who's put a lot of heart and soul into being a Toronto Maple Leaf.
Merci, PK. Thank you.
Presented this franchise with dignity, class, and pride.
Once again, let's go! His first!
Again, on the left circle, again, left shot, goes to the same rebound!
Plus seasons, the fans in Calgary and this organization have had the privilege and the honor of having one of the greatest players in the history of the game wear the flaming C.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me welcoming back number 12, Jerome.
Yet again to Antoine Vermette.